What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. Happy New Year to you all. I hope you guys are doing well, and I hope you guys are enjoying your new year, or at least trying to. So today's video, I have a new hair video for you guys, and I am sporting kinky curly hair. Kinky curly hair is one of my favorite textures to work with. I haven't worn a wig like this in some time now, but I am excited to pop this on for you guys. So I'm just showing you guys inside of the wig. It's a 360 wig lace closure, and it has the four combs inside. It has the elastic band if you want to wear this wig glueless. The first thing I'm doing is just removing the back end of the lace, since I'm not going to be gluing it all the way around. I'm not too familiar with that process yet, but once I do get familiar with that, I will have a dedicated video on how I apply a 360 wig. So I am using some brown press powder to fill in the light areas in the front where the scalp will be exposed. I'm using brown because I don't like when it shows, when the wig cap shows too yellow. I'd rather be a little bit darker than lighter, because if it's darker, I can definitely try to get it a little lighter. But I am on the brown skin tone, so I figure this hasn't done me wrong yet. It actually looks very natural. You guys will see once I pop the wig on to my hairline. So, as I mentioned before, this is a kinky curly wig. It's 16 or 18 inches, I forget, but I'll definitely put the information down in the description box below. And prior to me applying this wig, I did bleach the knots. I did not pluck it at all. This wig did come pre-plucked, which saved me a lot of time. It could be plucked a little bit more, but I'd rather leave it that way. Once the wigs get a little older, they do shed around the hairline, so I'd rather keep it that way, and then it'll naturally just fall off when it's ready to. So I am using a new lace glue this time around, as you guys can see, because I always use my holy grail ghost bond glue, but this time around I wanted to try the Isha lace bond glue. I've seen a couple of reviews on Instagram and on YouTube, and they're hit or miss, but I wanted to try it out for myself. I'm using three coats of the glue, letting it dry, and then I'm going to apply the lace. Now, reason for changing the glue is because I wanted to try a lace glue that is water resistant. Say for instance, if I go on vacation and I decide to dive in a pool, my wig will still be on my head. I don't need my wigs to fall off if I'm, you know, in a pool. Also, during the week I do work out. I work out about 4 to 5 days a week, and normally when I work out, I sweat excessively in my hair, my head, and what happens with the ghost bond glue is that it does lift sometimes. So I have the issue with, if I do have a day where I would work out and I have somewhere to go after I work out, I will at least look presentable. But unfortunately, with the ghost bond glue, the wig does lift once you do sweat excessively, or once water hits it, because it's not water resistant glue. So I actually, for this glue, the Isha glue, I actually purchased the remover as well, because I'm not going to test it out this time around on in water. Just want to see how it does with sweat. And then what I'm going to do is, if it works really well, I'll continue to use it, of course, and then I'll just remove the glue when I'm ready with the glue remover. So with that being said, I am just going to be applying the rest of the wig all around the hairline, and I will be back once I'm done with that. All right, so now that the lace is nicely placed onto my hairline, I'm going to be cutting the lace off. As you guys can see, this wig is very natural. It blends in with my hairline really, really well. The glue did a really good job when it came to applying it. I don't have any patches or any white areas. That's because it's crucial that you let the glue turn clear before applying the wig. So that's going to eliminate it looking white and ashy around the hairline. So I'm just pressing the lace into my hairline to make sure that everything is set in place. The right side of the right side or the left side, it depends. Every time I apply a wig, it never fails. I either have an issue with the left or the right side. So this time the right side was giving me an issue. For some reason, because this is a 360 wig, there's a certain way to cut the ear tabs so that it falls in place, but I didn't cut it prior to me installing the wig, so it did give me a hard time on the right side. But I was able to make it look really, really good, and it looked very presentable at the end. So what I'm doing here is just cutting the excess lace off, because I have the portion of the lace that I need laid down, and the excess I just cut off. If you want to wear this wig without baby hairs, you can definitely go right ahead and do that. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to style it. I did want to do a deep side part for this wig. For this wig application, so I'm parting the hair where I want it to be. Now you guys are gonna see some areas that are little like bald, look like it's like a little bald in that area. That's because the bleach did seep into the hair when I was bleaching the knots, which is okay because that's an easy fix. All you need to do is either get some eyeliner, liquid eyeliner, or even mascara, and just carefully place it in the area of where it should go. So what I'm doing here is I am using my hot comb to comb the area, the other side where the hair is gonna lay. You don't want that area to be puffy. Kinky curly hair, very, very puffy and voluminous, which I love, but you want it to be flat enough so that it lays on the side that you want your hair to lay. So once I'm done with that, I'm going to be applying my Got to Be gel to the areas, and then I'm going to be working on my baby hairs. I didn't do too much of a dramatic look with the baby hairs, but it's dramatic enough for me, so I'll be working on my baby hairs. And then you guys are gonna see that once I was done with my baby hair, I definitely wanted to show you guys how I style the curly hair. But with curly hair, it's super easy to maintain. All you need is your favorite mousse. My mousse of choice would be the Nairobi and the Lada Body. Those are the two mousses that I really love to use when wearing kinky curly hair. The Lada Body gives it a nice crunchy hold, and the Nairobi, it gives it a light hold, not as crunchy as the Lada Body, but either or, they really work really well. So unfortunately, I wasn't able to capture me putting the mousse onto my hair because my camera died, but it's very self-explanatory. You don't even need to use a ret, or you don't even need to use a wide tooth comb to comb out the hair at all. All you need to do is basically take your mousse and rake it through the hair, and you are good to go. As far as maintenance, very simple. I literally put my wig in a pineapple and go to sleep, wake up, and I am good to go. So that is the reason why I really love this texture, one of my favorite textures. As always, I will have the information on this hair down in the description box below, so check that out. And if you're new to my channel, welcome. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already. If you like what you see, give me a thumbs up. Comment down below. Let me know what you guys are feeling, not feeling. And follow me on Instagram if you haven't done so already. I definitely post more photos of and stories, my daily life. So definitely show me some love on that. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.